Ladies and gentlemen, it is a distinct honor and pleasure for me, on behalf of the government and the people of the Republic of Namibia, and indeed on my own behalf, to extend our warm congratulations and best wishes to Your Excellency, and through you, to the government and the people of the Republic of India, as you celebrate the 70th anniversary of the Republic Day. India was among the first friends of the Namibian people during the struggle for liberation that remains an appreciated developing partner since Namibia's independence 30 years ago. We recall with deep gratitude that India was the first country to grant SWAPO full diplomatic status, thereby enhancing the diplomatic stature and political prestige of our movement. And I'm happy to say this in the presence of Ambassador Suyamen Kalomo, who served in this capacity before Namibia's independence. Relations continues, and I'm also happy that I'm saying this in the presence of General Namolo, who also served as Namibia's High Commissioner to India after Namibia's independence. Your Excellencies, as you celebrate this joyous occasion, it is with a sense of satisfaction that we can reflect on our bilateral relations. And I'm happy you have elaborated on that. And I can only confirm the good relationship and the achievement we have achieved. Bilateral relationship between our two countries are excellent, but both our countries need to do more to further expand cooperation in trade, education, economic, and other social areas of advancement of our peoples and countries. I am saying this because development is a process, and you cannot be complacent with what we have achieved. Definitely, together in the past 30 years, we have achieved a lot together, but we need to do more. Namibia follows with keen interest the tremendous advance India has and continues to make in modernizing its economy and in the information technology. India's success in achieving sustainable economic growth and lifting millions out of poverty in a democratic post-election colonial setting is something Namibia would like to emulate. We hope that we can draw from your rich and varied experience as we continue to broaden our cooperation. We are committed to further strengthen the excellent bilateral relations and strong bonds of friendship between our two countries and peoples. I would like to take this opportunity to extend our sincere gratitude to the Foreign Service Institute of the Ministry of External Affairs of India for the well-coordinated and educational first special course of our diplomats that was held last December 2019 for 22 MIRCO staff members in New Delhi. And I have no doubt that the experience and the skill they have acquired will definitely enrich the work of our ministry. Your Excellencies, as members in good standing of the Non-Aligned Movement, which India is a founding member, Namibia and India constantly strive to uphold and respect the principle of sovereign equality, strong states, big and small. India and Namibia share a convergence of views on the long overdue reform of the United Nations Security Council, which should allow for equitable representation on an increase in the membership with all the rights and prerogatives enjoyed by all members of the Security Council. Your Excellency, I wish to end my remarks with a quote from the seminal speech delivered by the first Prime Minister of India, Jawaharlal Nehru, to the Indian Constituent Assembly on the eve of India's independence, towards the midnight hour on the 14th August 1947, and I quote, "At the stroke of the midnight hour, when the world sleeps, India will hope to lift to life and freedom the ambition of the greatest men of our generation has been to wipe every tear from every eye that may be beyond us, but as long as there are tears and sufferings, so long our work will not be over. Peace has been said to be indivisible, so is freedom, so is prosperity, and also disaster in his own words, one world that can no longer be split into isolated fragments." End of the quote. These words of extraordinary person were true 72 long years ago. They are unquestionable as relevant today at the beginning of the second decade of the 21st century, and they need to continue to guide us at all times.